We're proposing the AH-1Z Viper as the dedicated attack helicopter and the UH-1Y Venom as the combat multi-role. Our aircraft are the most advanced attack and combat multi-role in the world. These aircraft were born and brought to bear in the 21st century. Unlike many of the other aircraft in this potential tender, our aircraft have very modern technology and capability. And the one thing that they have that no other manufacturer produces is aircraft that have 85% commonality to the part number. So not only are the aircraft 85% common, and that means you can remove a rotor system off of the attack, it can go right onto the multi-role. The tail boom, the engines, the drivetrain, the cockpit avionics, they're all interoperable. It also makes it easier to train pilots and maintainers because they grow experience very rapidly in the ability to operate either aircraft from a cockpit station as a pilot or being able to work on and maintain the aircraft as a maintainer. It makes it much more efficient, not only for the military, but obviously for the taxpayers that have to support the aircraft. That said, the AH-1Z is probably the most lethal aircraft on the planet at this point in time. We have better speed, range, capability as far as the weapons mix. Our aircraft comes standard with air-to-air AIM-9 Sidewinder missiles. And so when you're operating in an area of contested airspace, the Marines are always being forward deployed. So they have a better weapons mix that makes them far more lethal to not only the ground units they may engage, but those close air support aircraft and the enemy helicopters. The Romanian interest in both the dedicated attack and a combat multi-role is the right choice. They're following the premier militaries of the world by not going after a single multi-role. Our goal at Bell Helicopter is to actually have technology that's transferred into Romania. Well, that means that we're going to be doing, and this is maybe a complex term, but a cradle-to-grave approach. And that means that from the inception of the program for the development of the aircraft, we'll be doing final assembly and checkout, which is a level of production that's done in Romania, and then it'll be grown gradually and incrementally based upon the total number of aircraft that are bought by the Romanian government. This is a very long-term, cradle-to-grave, from the very beginning to the very end program that will be done by the Romanians in Brașov. And then the long-term strategy and plan for the maintenance, repair, overhaul, we're talking 30, 40, 50 years, depending on how long Romania wants to operate this aircraft. So it is a long-term partnership. At final assembly, we'll bring in all that capability and technology. And then again, we'll continue to grow that. Hopefully, they'll be back for more aircraft besides the 24 and 21.
Do you have plans to sell these helicopters in neighboring countries?
So the answer to that is yes. We have a lot of interest, not only in the European region, but in the regions in Middle East and Asia. It would be something for consideration, again, if it's more efficient and more effective to be building aircraft here. So we've completed a transition study working with IAR Brașov, and we've been in negotiations with the government of Romania for really about the last 3.5 years. We're very near to their next step, which will be the delivery of an LOR for LOA for submission to the United States government. We're hoping that happens at the end of this year. The LOR for LOA will be the next step in the process. Until they actually sign the LOA, Romania is not committed to anything. It's just the next step in the negotiations to improve fidelity of pricing and make sure that the United States government, working with the Romanian government, gets exactly what they need at the exact price that they need it. Well, I can't tell you the exact price because we don't know exactly what they're going to ask for with respect to final numbers, what their support package is going to be. Remember, the key difference in an FMS case and a direct commercial sale from another manufacturer, the United States government in an FMS case is going to make sure they work with the partner to get the price to the exact point. So there's a definitization meeting that happens and they narrow it down. They eliminate, if there's no need for additional ground support equipment, they take it off the requirement list. So they'll be here working with the Romanians to make sure that they give them no more equipment or support equipment than they actually need. We're not gonna have them forced into anything. They're gonna get the aircraft, equipment, the training, the sustainment package that they need.